Okay, here we go. So my slide will cover five parts. I will give a little bit background introduction and show you how we select the substrate for co-digestion and how the co-digestion will affect the capital cost, operational cost, and the revenue. Okay, first the introduction. We know anaerobic digestion can provide us with lots of environmental benefits. Also, it's profitable to with biogas production. But recently, due to the breakthrough in the natural gas extraction technology, the electrical price was dropped down dramatically. It's reduced the revenue of AD project. So now comes the opportunity for the co-digestion. Co-digestion can significantly boost the economic of AD project by producing more biogas production and receiving tipping fees and the renewable credits. And also it's due to the balanced nutrients. So co-digestion have a synergetic effect. So it will make the co-digestion process more stable and efficient. There's lots of concerns also exist for the co-digestion. If the substrate was not carefully selected, there may contain the inhibitors, so that will inhibit the microbial organism and make the digester upset. Sometimes inorganic material will impact the digester performance and make the system clogged. And high concentration of fat, oil, grease, and will form the scum layer on the top of a digester and making the mixing problematic. High concentration of protein lipids will produce high amount of CO2 and hydrogen sulfate. This also will present as a contaminant for the biogas. Also due to the high organic concentration, the nutrient level will be increased in the effluent. Also, there's lots of regulations need to be met for all the substrate. Now let's see how we choose a substrate for a co-digestion project. Methane production from various substrate depends on their component. Switchgrass, meat, pasta have lots of carbohydrate, so it will produce lower amount of biogas. Dog food, cheese, we have a little bit more proteins, so it will produce more biogas. Ice cream, vegetable oils will have lots of lipids, so they produce higher amount of biogas. So there's lots of inhibitors may exist in the substrate. Fog and ammonia are common biological inhibitors. Fog will cause sludge flotation, digester foaming, and blockage of pipe and pumps, clogging of gas handling system. And also the hydrolysis product of fog is a launching fatty acid. It will cover all the bacteria surface and block the mass transfer process. Have lead to a reduced biogas production. Ammonia comes from degradation of protein. The most inhibitive species is free ammonia. Free ammonia concentration was in fact affected by pH, presence of iron, and temperature. Some chemical inhibitors like antibiotics, antifungals will also be also presented in the substrate. Sometimes the process washing down agent like acid, alkalines also presented in the substrate. Large particle of wheat straw, small particle of sawdust, which in the high lignin cellulosic content, it's very difficult to be broken down in the AD process, which will lead to a low biogas production and also a cause problem for the mixing. Struvite formation and inert material precipitation, it's a big issue that will clogging the pipes. here's a number of factors that we need to be considered when choosing the co-digestion substrate. Substrates are limited for the local availability due to the high transportation cost. High moisture content needs to be avoided because it will dilute the digester effluent and reduce the digester performance and reduce the biogas production. Larger particle size will affect the mixing, also will reduce biogas production. The inhibitors need to be avoided that will suppress the anaerobic bacteria. Nutrient balance needs to be considered. The carbon to nitrogen ratio needs to be controlled at a range of 15 to 45. And for the existing digester, the capacity of the digester need to be checked if they can handle additional organic waste. We need to get appropriate permitting for all the substrate to meet all the regulation requirement. The pH of the substrate need to be within the range of 7 to 8, and high alkalinity is wanted to ensure a better performance. Now let's see the capital cost. Sometimes the pre-screening process needs to be considered for the co-digestion substrate. The left figure shows there are some plastic bottles in the organic waste. The right figure shows the pre-screening process. Mixer macerators need to be involved for the solid type of substrate. Substrate first send to a macerator to reduce the particle size, and then send to a mechanical mixer to mix with dairy manure to make it homogeneous, make sure the digestion performance more stable. Buffer tank, receiving pit, and the metering system are used for the liquid type of feedstock. Sometimes the cover was placed on in the top of a buffer tank to reduce the odor release. Due to the extra biogas production, we need have a more engine set to convert all the biogas to capture the more revenues. This figure shows the engine set was doubled due to the high biogas production. Nutrient management is a big issue. In this case study, shows all the nutrients concentration was increased due to the co-digestion. So the if the local applied field application is not enough, so we need to consider the cost for the holding the effluent away from the digester. Operational cost consideration. Hauling cost is one of the largest operational cost. Hauling cost includes both to get the substrate to the digester or get the effluent away from the digester. The digester performance needs to be carefully monitored, and the laboratory tests need to be conducted regularly. When we have a new substrate, we need to do a biochemical methane potential test to estimate how much biogas can we get from those type of food waste. Also, anaerobic toxicity assay need to be when there's some potential inhibitors in the substrate. Revenue considerations. Revenue will be definitely increased by tipping fees and more electricity, or the biogas can be upgraded to renewable natural gas. We also will get more tax credit, carbon credit, and renewable credit. We also have a more co-product like fibers. The operational cost and capital cost will be increased by pretreatment facility and effluent hauling and extra engine set. Generally, the cost of operation cost and capital cost will be increased by 10% for the co-digestion project. As a summary, due to the increase of revenue, the co-digestion process can shorten the project payback period and increase the return on the investment. With that, we would like to thank all the funding agency, USDA NEPA, NRCS, and Washington State University, and Washington State Department of Ecology. With that, thank you all for your attention and would like to take any questions. Thank you.